Hello friends, here I have come again. I think you are all watching my class very closely. Before starting my class, I would like to wish a very happy new year to all of my students, all of my viewers. So kindly keep watching my videos and subscribe to my channels and do not forget to press the notification bell icon. However, so in this class, I would like to discuss some important questions for the upcoming competitive exam. So please keep watching my videos. So the first question, it is all about fill in the blanks. Here is a blank to the problem. Of air pollution in his speech. Options are there: Abbott, option B, Abbott, option C, Esclaimed, option D, mentions. So this is the question. Now have a close look over the sentence. He dashed to the problem of air pollution in his speech. This is the question. There are four options given. So avert, what is the meaning of avert? Avert means avoid it. This means not interested to talk about. It is just slide it away or avoid it. Avert, it is in the present tense, it is in the past tense. Exclaims, expression of extreme happiness or exuberance. Maybe it is an expression of some extremity. Mentioned means refers someone, cited something. So it is better to write avert here. You can say that why not avert? If avert is there, be careful. He is the third person singular number. So automatically in the simple present tense format, S must be added, but here is no S. So if you write avert, it will be a mistake. Then what to be written? Averted to be written. It is in the simple past tense. What is the other synonym for avert? You can say avoid it or ignore or connect. There are many meaning in this way. So you cannot select avert. If avert yes might have been there, we might have at least thought over this. I am not saying that this will be the answer, but we might have thought. But when this is not here, there is no question of thinking about this. So you have to select your answer in this way. So if you have any queries regarding this question, kindly drop your questions in the comment box. I will try to give answers to all of your questions. So this kind of question can be given in the exam in the form or in the shape of fill in the blanks. Now I would like to go for the next questions. The next question 2 would be very interesting. Rohan is the name of a person. Actually, it is called the proper noun, proper subjective noun. So magnanimous. That everyone is always dashed to in his project. This is the sentence. In his project. This is the sentence. What are the options? There are four options. Option A, Agar. Option B, enthusiastic. Option C, reluctant. Option D, ignorant. So there are four options, my students. So what is the meaning of magnanimous? Magnanimous actually means generous. Or in colloquial language, it is called noble. N-O-B-L. Okay. So he is so noble, he is so magnanimous, he is so generous that everybody is always either enthusiastic or eager. Here is a confusion. So be careful when eager is there and enthusiastic is there. In such sentences, you should always go for the word eager. But in the absence of eager, you can select enthusiastic. There is a bit of confusion over this, but if you maintain what I am saying, there will be no confusion. As eager always gives more stress to the sentence instead of enthusiastic. You can say that what is the other synonym for enthusiastic? So there are many synonyms for enthusiastic. The most important is inspiring. Inspiring is also one kind of word that always indicates some kind of enthusiasm. So however, that's a different question. So if eager and enthusiastic both are there in a question side by side in any option, you should always walk through the path of eager. As eager in this case, T-H-E-S-E, always give more stress to the sentence. So the appropriate answer will be eager, E. So kindly keep watching my video and subscribe to my channel. Okay. So I will upload more and more such videos, more and more such tricks. Even I will also upload more and more grammatical relationship with mathematics. However, that's a different thing. Now I would like to go for the next question. If you have any queries, kindly drop your questions. I'll try to answer your questions. Okay. Now if we talk about the next question, it is all about incorrectly spelled word. Selection. Select the incorrectly spelled word. You have to select one word. What are the words? Words are there in this format. Hygiene. Fascist. Option C, career. Option D, apparel. Hygiene means health science. This is called hygiene. Fascist, you know, has originated from fascism. Career, it does not need any kind of explanation, I think so. Because you are all studying, you are all watching my videos for bettering your career. Apparel means one kind of clothing, one kind of garment, you can say. So, the mistake doesn't lie here. But here the mistake. What is the spelling of hygiene? H-Y-G-I-E-N-E. Actually, hygiene means health science. So, my students, practice your spellings at home so that you will have a vivid knowledge of English spellings. So, you have to select this answer. There is a bit of confusion. Many say that there should not be E, but here you should not have any confusion, as if you turn over the pages of hardcore English grammar, you will find that this is the only spelling. This means this is the only right spelling. E must be there. In today's life, we are also changing many spelling, which does not mean that you will change the whole thing. Okay. Now I would like to go for my next question. Kindly keep watching videos and subscribe to my channels. And also press the notification bell icon. For question number 4 is very interesting. Select the appropriate passive voice. What is the sentence? Please guide me. Option A, you are requested to guide me. Option B, you have been requested to guide me. Option C, you were requested to guide me. Option D, you are being. Being is called the present participle. Take it into account. Being is called the present participle. Always indicate some, always symbol some kind of dynamism. Requested to guide me. So these are the 4 options. These are the 4 options. Now, before chalking out your answer, you have to think about the category of the sentence. It is actually called the imperative sentence. Imperative sentence. This means it indicates some kind of advice or request or solution or vice versa. So, imperative sentences are there. Voice change must, should, whatever you say, be in the simple present form. But the most important thing is that subject doesn't get shown here. This means it is understood. So when the subject is understood, you should take you as subject. As it is in the simple present tense, automatically, while passivizing the voice of simple present tense, is, am, or are is used. This is the main verb. So, it is better to write you are. And you all know that what kind of implication is there? Requested. You have to go through the root of the sentence. Request or order or advice or solution. Then you have to write the same thing while passivizing. So, it is better to write requested as please is there. Please always indicate some kind of request to guide me. This will be the answer. So you can say that all these have been where being, no question of being, where past have been indicates that present perfect tense. So all are omitted. What is left? This is the answer. So you have to select your answer in this way in the exam hall. But be careful, instead of you are, we can also pacify this with some other thing like late. In my upcoming videos, I will show how to transfer this active into passive with the application of late. But kindly keep watching my videos and subscribe to my channel. This is my class for the day. If you have any queries regarding the class, kindly drop your questions in the comment box. I will leave no stone unturned to give answers to all of your queries. Till then, have a nice Happy New Year. Enjoy your Happy New Year. But do not forget that in our country, Omicron is already on the rise. So you should make a balance between your happiness and the rising cases of Corona. So again, I will upload video. So have a nice year. Have a good day. Till tomorrow, I would like to say that be safe and make others safe. Okay, bye.